Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video lecture, we will solve few numericals related to several topics including the photogrammetry and errors and contouring and related to offset and many more related to Bowditch rule as well. So let us begin with the series. The first question is, if required photograph size is 250 mm by 250 mm, we are given with the size of the photograph. And the scale required, you are given with the scale. The scale is 1 is to 10,000. The longitudinal overlap and the side overlap. The PL is given as 0.6. The PS is given as 0.36. You are asked to calculate the number of photographs required. I have already covered the theory related to this topic, but a numerical was important to solve. So the number of photographs required to cover an area, the length of the area is given as 40,000 meters. Let us convert everything in meters, and the width is given as 30,000 meters, that is 30 kilometers. So this is the case 2 of the number of photographs. Since the area of the ground is not given, instead the length and width of the ground are given. So you can calculate the photographs in this direction as L1. It will be equal to 40,000, that means L divided by 1 minus PL into L divided by S. This is L is the length of the photograph. This is the formula that we use to calculate N1. So the length of the ground, capital L, is 40,000. 1 minus PL is 0.6. The length of the photograph is given as 250 millimeter. So we can write it directly in terms of meter and divided by S. What is S? S is 1 divided by 10,000. So it will come here instead of here. You will get N1 as 41. So this is the N1, that means number of photographs required in this direction. Similarly, you can calculate N2 by using the formula of B divided by 1 minus PS into B divided by S. The B is given as 30,000 divided by 1 minus 0.36 into B is 0.25 into 10,000. So N2 will turn out to be 19.75. we can round it off since the photograph cannot be in decimals, so it will be 20. I am sorry, the formula is this, plus 1. So when you will solve this with along with plus 1, I have shown you the answers. N1 will turn out to be 41 and N2 will be 20. Now the total number of photographs you can calculate by multiplying N1 and N2. So it will be 20 multiplied by 41, so it is 820 photographs. So this is the number of photographs that you require in the photogrammetric survey to cover this much of area. Now moving to the next question, and the next question is related to errors. You are given with the side of rectangle as 100 plus 0.05 meters. This is one side, this is the side, and this is the error that is involved in this side, plus minus. And the second side is 150 plus minus 0.06 meters. Now you are asked to calculate the probable error in area. So you know, suppose x is 100, ex is 0.05, y is 150, and ey is 0.06. You are asked the error in x multiplied by y, since the area is this multiplied by this. So you need to calculate the error in this multiplied by this. So you know the formula, exy square plus yex square, and the under root of this quantity will lead you to the total error. So 100 multiplied by ey is 0.06 square plus y is 150 and it is 0.05 square, and the under root of this whole quantity. You will get the ES value as, it is always plus minus 9.60. meters. This is the error in the area of this rectangle. Now moving to the next question. The next question is again related to errors. You are given with the standard deviation as 20 and the number of observations are given as 10. There are four parts in the question. The first part asks you to calculate the most probable error. You know what is the formula for most probable error? 0.6745 sigma. So it will be 0.6745 times 20. So it will be equal to plus minus of 13.49. The second part is you are asked to calculate the standard error of mean. You know how to calculate the standard error of mean? It is sigma divided by root n. Sigma is 20 and n is 10. So it will come out to be plus minus 6.324. The third part is most probable error of mean. You know how to calculate most probable error of mean? For mean, you just need to divide it by this particular error by root n. So it will be 13.49 divided by root 10. So it will come out to be plus minus 4.265. The next part is asking you to calculate maximum error. The maximum error not in mean, the maximum error in the observations. So it is 3.29 times sigma plus minus. So it will come out to be plus minus 65.8. So these are the required answers for these questions. Now moving to the next question. The next question is related to weights. There are three angles that are given, angle A, angle B and angle C, 10 degree, 20 degree and 40 degree. And along with the angles, the weights are given, 2, 1 and 3 respectively. The errors are given in these angles. You need to calculate the mean. The mean will not be calculated normally as you calculate A plus B plus C divided by 3. It is not the way to calculate mean when the angles and weights are also given. So you need to multiply the weights along with their angles and divide it by A plus B plus C. So what is the weight? 2 multiplied by 10 plus 1 multiplied by 20 plus 3 multiplied by 40 divided by 2 plus 1 plus 3. So when you will solve this, you will get it as 26.66 degrees. So this is the weighted mean. The second part is the weight of angle A plus angle B plus angle C. What is the weight of this? So in the topic of weights, I told you how to calculate the weight of addition of any quantities. It is calculated by this formula. So 1 divided by what is the weight of A? The weight of A is 2, the weight of B is 1 and the weight of C is 3. So the way when you solve this, it will turn out to be 0.5454. This is the weight of addition of these three angles. The third part, and it is asking you to calculate the weight of angle A divided by 2 and 2 times of angle A. I told you when you divide any quantity with any constant, then the weight gets k square times weight of A, and in this case it gets weight of A divided by k square. So what is the weight of A? Weight of A is 2. When you multiply it with the square of 2, it will get 2 into 2 into 2, it will be 8, and in this case it will be 0.5. the weight will reduce and the weight will multiply 4 times in this particular case. The next part is you are asked to calculate the probable error in angle A plus angle B. You know how to calculate the probable error? The error in angle A is given as 0.02 and error in angle B is given as 0.01. So when you add, you just need to do this. That means 0.02 square plus 0.01 square and the under root of this. So it will turn out to be 0.022 degrees. This is the error that is involved with angle A plus angle B. The last question but not the least is asking you to calculate the error in angle C, the square of angle C. So I told you the error in x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1 multiplied by ex. So 2 multiplied by angle C and the error involved in angle C. This is how you will calculate this. You need to differentiate this. So 2 multiplied, what is the value of angle C? It is 40 degree. And what is the error in angle C? It is 0.002 degree. So when you will solve this, you will get it as 1.6 degrees. The next question is based on to calculate the limiting length of offset. So the question says that the find the limiting length of offset so that the displacement of a point on a paper may not exceed. The maximum displacement is given as delta max 0.025 centimeters. And the offset, the theta of the offset was laid at an angle of 3 degree out from its true direction, and the scale is given as 1:2000. 1 centimeter is to 10 meters. So this is the diagram. This is the actual direction in which the offset should have been laid, but instead it is laid in this, I should make this dotted, in this direction, and this is theta. You know the formula to calculate the limiting length of offset when there is an error only in direction. L sin theta divided by S. See, in this case, this is not S. S is this 1000. 1 in S. This is S in this case. And this should be less than equal to 0.025 centimeters. From here, you have to calculate the value of L. So, L into sine 3 degree divided by 1000 should be less than equal to 0.025. From here you can calculate L in terms of centimeters, so it will turn out to be 4.776 meters when you will divide it by 100. So this is the maximum length of the offset that should be laid out for this particular purpose, so that error on the paper does not gets more than 0.025 centimeters. Now the next question is based on the trapezoidal formula. You should know what are the trapezoidal and what are the prismoidal formulas from mathematics. So the question says that from a topographical map, areas enclosed by contour lines for a proposed dam are given below. Find the volume of impounded water using the trapezoidal formula. You are given with contour and the area enclosed. You can see the difference in the elevation in the contours is equal to 5. This is what it is H in the formula. So the trapezoidal formula is V equals to H times A1 plus AN divided by 2 plus A2 plus AN minus 1. So this is the formula that is called as trapezoidal formula. So you just have to place the values. H is 5. The difference in the contours is 5. A1 is 20. It is 1100. And the rest areas are 100 plus 400 plus 900. Since these areas are in hectares, but you're asked to calculate the volume in meter cube, you have to multiply it by 10 to the power 4 to convert it in meter square, and this is already in meter. So the volume will be 9800 into 10 to the power 4 meter cube. This is the required volume using the trapezoidal formula. You could have solved this question with the prismoidal formula as well. You just need to change the formula. The pattern will remain the same. Now moving on to the next question. The next question is based on contour again, and you are asked to calculate the horizontal equivalent. I guess the contour interval on a map is, you are given with contour interval is 12 meters. That means the vertical distance between the contour lines is 12 meters. If upward gradient of 1 in 20, this is 20 meters, so this will be 1 meter. This is the meaning of 1 in 20. Upward gradient is required to be drawn between two points. What shall be the horizontal equivalent? You are asked to calculate HE, the horizontal equivalent. See, there is a formula trick, or there can be a normal way to solve this question. The formula is, the horizontal equivalent can be calculated by CI multiplied by this S. This is 1 in S. So this is S in this case. You can calculate it by multiplying 12 multiplied by 20. So you can directly get horizontal equivalent as 240 meters. But there is another way also to calculate this question. See, the contour interval is 12 meters. That means if there is one contour, then the next contour will have an elevation of 12 meters. The elevation difference is 12 meters. You need to calculate the horizontal equivalent for this case. The upward gradient is represented by this. This is 1 meter. This is 12 meter. So what will be the horizontal distance for this 12 meter? If for 1 meter it is 20 meter, then for 12 meter it will be 12 multiplied by 20. Simple. It will again turn out to be 240 meters. You can also remember the formula. The formula is very easy. Moving on to the next question. The next question is based on LMT and GMT. For this, let me tell you a very small concept. LMT is equal to GMT plus minus theta divided by 15. What is GMT? GMT is Greenwich Mean Time. It is also called as Standard Time. LMT is Local Mean Time. This is a time that is not of the standard meridian. Any meridian can be a local meridian, but there is only one standard meridian. So what is theta? Theta is the difference between the angles of a standard meridian and a local place of which the time is measured, the local mean time. So you will understand this better with the help of a question. Local mean time at a place located in longitude. So there is a place that is located in longitude 90 degree and 40 minutes east. Now the standard time is given as, you are given with GMT. GMT is given as 6 hours and 6 degree and 30 minutes. 6 hours and 30 minutes means 6 degree and 30 minutes. The standard meridian is given as, SM is the standard meridian, 82 degree and 30 minutes east. LM is the local meridian. Local meridian is given as 90 degree 40 minutes east. Now see, suppose this is a standard meridian. This local meridian is towards the east or it's towards the west. It is greater than this standard meridian. That means if this is 82 degree 30 minutes, then definitely this local meridian would be somewhere here. 90 degree and 40 minutes towards the east. This is west and this is east. It is towards the east of the standard meridian. That means our sign will be positive. The sign is positive for east and the sign is negative for west, just like in the case of magnetic declination. If it would have been, the local meridian would have been, suppose 80 degree east, then that means the declination is, that means the theta is in westward direction since it is less than the standard meridian. So this is how you calculate the theta. The theta will be the difference of these two. The theta will be simply the difference of these two. But the sign will depend whether the local meridian lies to the east of the standard meridian or it lies to the west of the standard meridian. In this case, it is lying to the east of standard meridian. Hence the theta is in positive sense. What will be the theta? Theta will be calculated by 90 degree 40 minutes minus 82 degree 30 minutes. So the theta is coming out to be 8 degree and 10 minutes. And you know GMT, what is GMT? So you can calculate the time at that local meridian. It will be 6 degree 30 minutes plus 8 degree 10 minutes divided by 15. Either you can convert this whole thing into degrees. This will be 6.5 degrees and this will be, how will you convert this in degrees? 10 divided by 60 plus 8. This will be the degree and you will have to divide it by 15. So when you will solve this complete thing, the LMT will turn out to be 7 degree 2 minutes and 40 seconds. So this is present in option number D. This is the local mean time. Such questions can be asked in different manners as well. So you have to do a good practice of such questions. Now there is a question that is related to Bodich rule. I have not explained that question since that question has very less chances to come in examination like GATE. It can come in subjective examinations like ESE mains. But there are extremely less or rare chances that such a question will be asked in GATE examination since such question is very long. You can look out that question. I have provided a PDF of Bodich rule in the description below. You can check out that question. If you still face any problem in any of the step, you can ask in the comment section. Thank you.